In this video, you're going to learn the exact steps to take to install Oracle on your Mac computer. This video includes step-by-step instructions on downloading and setting up the required software, and explanations of the configurations you need to set, such as connecting to the database. So if you want to set up Oracle on your Mac computer, you'll love this video. Let's get right into it. Installing an Oracle database on a Mac computer is a bit different to installing it on a Windows or a Linux computer. Oracle doesn't support running an Oracle database directly on a Mac computer. You can't install Oracle Express, for example, in the same way that you can on a Windows computer. The good news is that you can use a virtual machine. To get set up with Oracle on your Mac, the general process is shown in this video. Here's an overview of the process. Step 1 is to get VirtualBox. Step 2 is to download the Oracle Developer Virtual Machine. Step 3 is where we set it up, and step 4 is running the Oracle Virtual Machine. And step 5 is where we test using SQL Developer. Now, there are other ways to access an Oracle database on a Mac, such as using a Docker container or a cloud-hosted database, such as Oracle Cloud or AWS. This video doesn't cover those methods, but I'll outline those in another video. Let's take a look at the requirements and then we'll get into the steps. So what do you need to be able to run Oracle using a VM on a Mac? The requirements for running a virtual machine are listed on Oracle's website and are shown here. You need at least 2 GB of RAM, 15 GB of free hard drive space, and at least a 2 GHz processor and admin privileges on your computer. So most computers manufactured in the last few years should be able to handle this. My current Mac is a 2018 MacBook Pro with 8 GB of RAM and a 256 GB hard drive, and this runs the VM pretty well. On my previous MacBook Air, which was a 2015 model with 4 GB of RAM, it actually ran pretty slowly, because the 4 GB RAM is split between 2 GB for the VM and 2 GB for the macOS, which brings both systems to a crawl. MacBook Airs are not designed to be able to run intensive programs such as VMs. If you really want to use Oracle on a Mac, but don't quite meet the requirements, you can use Oracle Live SQL, which is a web-based Oracle database. So assuming you want to install Oracle on your Mac, let's look at the steps. The first step to getting Oracle on your Mac is to download a program called VirtualBox. This program allows you to run virtual machines, which are self-contained operating systems. It will let you run a Windows or a Linux operating system inside your Mac. I suggest VirtualBox because it's free, and Oracle provides a ready-made file that you can use with it. For me, it also performs better than the alternatives. To download VirtualBox, go to the VirtualBox website, which is virtualbox.org/wiki/download. The current version is shown at the top of the page. Click on OS X Hosts. This is a direct link to a .dmg file, which is the installer file for Mac. The file will begin downloading. It's approximately 120 megabytes. Once the file is downloaded, open it. Double-click the virtualbox.pkg icon in the window that appears. Click Continue if a message appears about installing the package, then click Continue on this welcome screen. The installer will tell you how much space VirtualBox will take up, which is approximately 251 megabytes. Click Install. Enter your password if you're prompted for this. The program will now be installed. Once it's completed, it will inform you that the installation was successful. Click Close, and then move the installer to the trash. Now, did you get an error saying the installation had failed? I got this error when attempting to install VirtualBox in May 2020, running macOS Catalina 10.15.4. So how can you resolve this? I've listed the steps on a blog post that outlines this process, which you can read in the description. I won't go into the details now, but it involves unlocking a process on the Mac and then trying again. Now you've got VirtualBox installed, you need to download the file that contains the Oracle database. This is the virtual machine and is provided by Oracle. It's called the Oracle Developer VM or Oracle Developer Day VM, as it was originally created for developers, but it has expanded since then. To download the file, visit the Oracle Developer Day download page here. I'll have a link in the description for this. This page lists the versions of the software it comes with. At the time of recording, this is Oracle Linux 7 with Oracle Database 19.3. Scroll to the bottom of the page and click the Oracle DB Develop VM link. On the pop-up that appears, check the box to accept the license agreement and click the green download button. You'll be asked to log in to your Oracle account. If you have an account, enter your details. If you don't have an account, you can create one. It's easy and free. Once you've logged in, the Developer Days VM file will start downloading. It has an OVA extension. This file is about 7 GB, so it may take a while. I've had no issues downloading it with Chrome, but you may want to use a download manager if your connection isn't very good. So once you've downloaded the Oracle VM file, it's time to set it up. Open VirtualBox. I do this by pressing Command Space and typing in VirtualBox on the Mac. Once VirtualBox is open, click File and then click Import Appliance, or click the Import button at the top of the main screen. The Appliance to Import screen is displayed. Click the Choose File button on the right of the text box, which is the little yellow folder icon with the green arrow. Select the Developer Days OVA file you just downloaded and click Open. There's no need to extract the file before opening it. Leave the source as the local file system. Then click on the Continue button. The Appliance Settings screen will show some information about the imported file. Click Import on this Application Settings screen. Click Agree on the pop-up that appears. The import process will begin. The process took about 2 minutes for me. Once the installer is finished, you should see Oracle Developer Days powered off in the left panel of the VirtualBox window. This means the VM is installed but not running. Now the installation has finished, it's time to run the Oracle VM. To run the virtual machine, click once to select Oracle DB Developer VM, and then click the green start arrow. There will be a minute or so of a blank screen with white text as the virtual machine loads and then a black screen. A Linux desktop will appear, and a moment later a terminal window will appear that looks like this. One thing to note, in previous versions of VirtualBox in this virtual machine, we had to take extra steps to make the VM visible to the host, which is the Mac that you're running the virtual machine on. We also had to set up port forwarding, which would allow us to enter in an IP address such as localhost on the Mac and have it forward to the virtual machine. However, this configuration is already done in the latest version, so these steps are no longer needed. Once the VM is running, as mentioned earlier, we can connect to it using SQL Developer or another IDE. The last step is to test this connection using SQL Developer. Open SQL Developer on your Mac. If you haven't downloaded it, you can download it from the Oracle website. Create a new connection by clicking on the green plus icon. Now enter these details for your connection. For name, enter whatever you like. A name such as VirtualBox Oracle is okay if you can't think of anything. Username is HR and password is Oracle. Check Save Password if you don't want to enter the password every time. Hostname is localhost, and the port is 1521. Select the service name instead of SID, and enter a service name of ORCL, and leave the connection type as basic. Your connection screen should look something like this. Click Test to test the connection. The message should say Success, which means the connection has worked. If it says listener refused the connection with the following error, 12514, then you likely have the service name incorrect. If it says listener refused the connection with the following error, 12505, then you likely have selected SID instead of service name. If it says test failed, error 01017, invalid username, password, login denied, then you likely have an incorrect username or password, or one of several other issues. I've linked to an article below about connection issues, so if you have connection issues here, then try some of the steps in that article. Click Save to save your connection to the list. Click Connect. After a moment, a new SQL worksheet window is opened in this new connection. You can now run SQL queries on Oracle on your Mac. This will work for as long as you have the virtual machine running in the background. To test this, you can run this query. Select star from v$version. This will show the current version of the Oracle database. Your Mac can now access your Oracle database running on your own virtual machine. Well done. Once you've finished with your Oracle SQL session, you can shut down your VM. To do this, go to Machine and then ACPI Shutdown. The virtual machine will go back to a powered off state when it's done. So that's how you can install Oracle on your Mac computer. If you've learned something new from this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel. If you want to learn more about database design and development, visit databasestar.com. That's where I share my best database-related content. So which step from this tutorial was the most helpful? Was it the ability to use an Oracle VM that's already been made, or the specific connection details to use, or something else? Thanks for watching.